Hi, welcome everyone. There is a massive world-class power transformer plant that is underway in Nigeria. Integrated in this plant will be a high voltage testing laboratory plus a second factory that will manufacture solar cells. This is not an assembly plant. They will manufacture all components locally when the plant is ready. Groundbreaking will be done in Abuja in September, that's a few days from now. This plant will be the first of its kind in Nigeria when it is completed. Also, when they become operational, they won't just be supplying the massive Nigerian economy with power transformers and solar cells, they will be exporting to other parts of the world. Yes, Nigeria has a competitive advantage because of its geographical location. This can't be said enough. Consumer products manufactured in Nigeria are cheaper for someone buying them from Europe or America because of its proximity. Nigerian goods can be delivered quickly to Europe or America, whether by air or sea, unlike Southeast Asia that will take much longer to deliver. If Nigerian manufacturing and supply chain can reach the level of China, Nigeria can actually become a cheaper alternative to foreigners buying consumer goods. In terms of shipping costs, Nigeria beats all Southeast Asian countries, hands down. In terms of wages, Nigeria is actually lower than many countries. Some entry-level factory workers earn less than $100 per month. Before we continue on the many advantages of setting up manufacturing in Nigeria, let's see the people behind this massive solar cell plant. Have you subscribed to our channel? Subscribe now to our channel if you haven't and enable notification. Also, make sure to join our channel membership, which is like Patreon, so that you can donate and support our channel. Thanks for your support. Now, let's see how this massive factory came about. It was established by the federal government through its agency, the National Agency for Science and Engineering Infrastructure, NASENI. They have a partnership with China Great Wall Industry Corporation. The aim here is to set up this massive factory that will manufacture power transformers and solar cells, which are imported heavily in Nigeria. Although there are companies that manufacture power transformers locally in Nigeria, the Nigerian economy is actually very huge and can accommodate other players. The demand for power transformers is huge and will continue to grow because of the expansion of the Nigerian economy and also because of the rehabilitation of the power distribution networks around the country. So this company that is co-owned by the government will compete with others in the power transformer industry. On solar cell manufacturing, there's a company that does that in Lagos already, but it's not clear if they import their solar cells or if they make them locally. If they import the solar cells, then this new company will stop that money flowing abroad. Anyway, whichever it is, the entry of this new company into the solar cell industry is a welcome development. Companies operating in Nigeria don't just depend on the huge Nigerian market. They have the African market on their doorstep and, of course, Europe, America, and other parts of the world. In preparation for the start of operations of the massive plant, 60 Nigerian engineers have already undergone training on transformer production line and high voltage testing. More will be going for training in a few weeks, where they will learn how to produce solar cells. This is the holy grail of solar panel manufacturing. If solar cells are made in Nigeria, it will lead to manufacturing of solar panels. And considering the fact that many households are not connected to the national grid, this is a sure way of equipping many homes with off-grid solar systems. Although the government is doing that to some extent through the rural electrification program. There's also solar mini-grids installed in many federal universities in Nigeria, like this one in Unizik, Awka. Click on the top right corner to watch more of the mini-grid in Unizik that supplies 24-hour electricity to the campus. Solar cell manufacturing in Nigeria will definitely increase the penetration of solar power, especially in the north, where there is heavy sunshine. Even Nigerian entrepreneurs like Mustafa, who just finished building this 12-seater van, can make do with more solar charging stations to charge his electric vehicles. Not only Mustafa, but other companies that make electric vehicles. The more charging stations we have, the more people will buy electric vehicles. More on the advantages of manufacturing consumer goods in Nigeria. In a world where Nigeria is in close proximity to two mega consumer markets in the world, the United States and Europe are huge markets where many companies in the world try very hard to push their products. China has the advantage of efficiency in the supply chain of components and parts needed in manufacturing a particular product. For instance, if you want to assemble a computer, you find out that all parts needed to assemble it can be gotten within 1 kilometer radius. It makes for a huge efficiency and cost saving because of proximity. Also, when you have different companies in close proximity making parts that are needed to make a product, it makes it easy to scale things up very quickly. This is the capability that China has over everyone. In Nigeria, there are many free trade zones that are supposed to replicate what China is doing, but they don't have factories that complement each other. China also has cheap labor, or used to have, because they now have a huge middle class. Most importantly, they exercise a lot of control of the raw materials needed in manufacturing. Even in Nigeria, a lot of Chinese companies are into mining of many metals, which they export to China. So with all these advantages, why are Chinese companies investing in Nigeria? Apart from business expansion and getting closer to the biggest market in Africa, they realize that profit margin in Nigeria is higher than in China. Also, competition is not stiff in Nigeria compared to China. In fact, there are industries where you have virtually no competition because the products are all imported. Also, if a Chinese company that exports their products to Western countries swaps location with Nigeria, all things being equal, they will actually not just be more profitable in Nigeria, they will have more turnover because of the cost savings on shipping alone. They can afford to reduce the price of their products based on that, which a company operating in China wouldn't afford to do. These are some of the reasons many Chinese and Indian companies are investing massively in Nigeria. The government is making it easy for them with free trade zones where they can set up factories and export their products with free tax incentives. Look at Lekki Free Trade Zone, for instance. There's a world-class seaport opening there very soon. All it takes for a foreigner to set up a factory there is to register a company, bring in your equipment, and of course build your factory and start exporting your products to the world. This is exactly what many did. Look at Olam Nigeria Limited, they are Nigeria's largest non-oil exporter. So if you're a foreigner thinking about setting up manufacturing in Nigeria, you can come to Nigeria even without applying for a visa in any Nigerian embassy abroad. You can get on a plane and take advantage of visa on arrival that Nigeria offers to business executives. Remember to check if you qualify before boarding your flight. Many people always ask why Nigerians aren't the ones setting up these massive factories, that the Chinese, Indians, and other foreigners are taking over the Nigerian economy. Well, Nigeria is a liberal country that is not lacking inventors and creative entrepreneurs, but the major impediment that creative Nigerians lack is access to funding. Thousands of SMEs could be pumping out finished goods in Nigeria if they had access to funding. Proving the viability of your business is not easy, not to talk of the conditions, moratorium, interest rates, and the collateral required by the banks. Although the Bank of Industry supports a lot of industries, they give loans to companies on favorable interest rates. Companies like Innocent got loans from Bank of Industry, but many SMEs can't still access the loans. If many people had properties they could use as collateral, they could sell them and invest the money in their small factory instead of going through the rigors of loan application, which will also prove that they actually believe 100% that the SME they want to invest in is viable with a favorable return on investment. All right, we hope you enjoyed the video. Make sure to subscribe to our channel and enable notification to be notified, not just to watch updates about this project as construction progresses, but also other massive project videos that will be uploaded on our channel. Also, make sure to join our channel membership to donate and support our channel. Special thanks to all those who have joined our membership and donated to our channel. Till next time, bye-bye.